Hey, I'm Eddie. I want to learn how to ride a unit cycle. This is what I'm going to get.
Wow! Open it. Is it hard?
Yeah. It was the hardest thing I ever done. When I started trying, I always fell. I keep falling, and I couldn't stop falling because I was just learning. I could barely move without falling. And when I fall, I keep trying like I never give up, because I do never give up. When I was unicycling, it was still even hard to stay seated because I was still comfortable by standing up, because usually when you walk, you stand up, but when you unicycle, you sit. After like 10 falls, you might notice you got a smidge better, and that's always exciting. I decided to ride to school with my unicycle, because when I rode my bike, I was too tired. Day two of learning how to ride a unicycle. On day one, I kept making the same mistake. So then I decided to practice with the railing, and I got better. But whenever I was watching a video on me unicycling, we noticed that I was bent forward and my unicycle was backwards. So if you were hanging onto a rail, then you wouldn't fall. But if you were let go, you would just fall backwards. Obviously, when you run, you lean forward. But can you imagine if you ran and you were leaning backwards? If you want to try, you can try that at home. Day three! On day three, I was getting better because I was hanging onto the railing with one arm and balancing with the other. They say you should be moving your arms as much as you can to keep your balance, because if you do not, you would just fall every time. We decided to go back to the hockey rink, and I was a smidge better. But I was still falling a lot. My dad says a saying, and it's this: fall 9 times, get up 10. And I have no idea what that saying even means. How can you get up more times than you fall? Because what I say is fall 9 times, get up 9 times. On day 4, I seem to be worse, so we went back to the basics. When you hold on to the wall and you go back and forth, and you learn how to like sort of keep your balance. And also, a really good tip is never ever stop in the dead zone. What the dead zone is it's when one foot is down and one foot's up. You never want to stop in there, because then you can't pedal as much, as good. At the end of the day, I ended the day first rated.
Okay, come here. Yeah. So, can you unicycle yet, Eddie? Are you gonna give up? Why not? What would your advice be to someone who can't do it yet?
The word.
What?
The word, which is don't. The word. Which is don't give up. By day 5, I have already practiced for 11 hours, and then I started to get frustrated. So then I quit it early that day. On day 6, my dad bought me elbow pads, knee pads, and wrist guards, but it was pretty late because it was only day 6. And it was like something was clicking in my brain that was remembering all the steps to unicycling. A bicycle is a unicycle with training wheels. On day 7, I was getting better and better, like each 20 minutes. At the end of the day, my goal was to go across the whole hockey rink. Do you think I made it? Let's see. One tip everyone gives is to look forward when you're unicycling because you'll have better posture. Would you look down when you're walking? No. So you would probably look forward when you're unicycling too. Learning something new is also kind of fun and funny. It's really hard for a long time until suddenly you just get it and then you know how to do it. Once you're good at it, it's really easy for us. And that is forever, not just for a little bit of time, like 2 minutes. By day 8, I know, learned how to unicycle. Button. See you later.